In this video, we're going to look at extending our lighting circuit so we can have another light come on when this one comes on. So it's traditionally wired, three plate method, and we've seen in two previous videos, first of all, how to make the connections in here and neatly do them. And then we went on to work out how we could come from here with another feed, a line, a neutral, CPC to another area to wire, say, an outside light, a loft light, or another room. But this time, I want to see if we can take a cable from here that actually turns on another light in the same area, so we've got two lights coming on at the same time when the switch is operated. I've installed my cable into the lighting point here, and as we've seen before, we've just got to confirm we get our conductors around the right way to make it easier for ourselves. We've got a blue one, brown one, and our sender bare CPC. But now we've got to think, right, so this is now going to take a switching line, a neutral, and a CPC to the other light in the area that wants to come on when this one comes on. So this time, the blue is going to be a neutral, whereas before we did see that when we had the switching line one here, actually that it was not a neutral, it was identified with brown sleeving as a switching line conductor. So this time, it's going to be the brown one that's the switching line, the blue one that's the neutral, and the bare one, as always, is going to be our circuit protective conductor. So let's strip them back once we've confirmed we've got it in the right place. So that's the neutral. Neutral's this side. What did we do before? We pulled it out slightly, we twist it round, and we send it back in. And you can see now we've got our neutral connection on the correct side, and our brown one, which is not going to be permanent line this time as it was in the last video, it's going to be our switching line conductor. So I'm getting used to using these now. Let's bring in my twin and earth or twin and CPC strippers and pull off and push that in. So this light will come on, and then the new light where this other cable was going to end up is going to come on at the same time. So that means we need to take a neutral across the new light fitting, and we need to bring down a switching line as well. We saw in previous videos I didn't use the outside connections here. This would be where the flex would be connected, say for our ceiling rose and pendant, or for our bat and lamp holders. And I don't recommend you take it out because it gives you another job every time to reconnect it. But I've taken ours out in order to make it easy for you to see what we're doing. So this other light will need a neutral, it will need a CPC, and it will need a switching line. As we said in the previous video, it doesn't matter if we put more than one conductor into any of these holes, but I'm going to try and leave the outside ones for that flexible cable. So let's insert our neutral. So we're going to bring our neutral in. I want it to dress neatly like the other ones. So I'm going to bring it around to there. And this will take a neutral across to our next point. We've got our strippers again. Maybe that's a fraction too much copper. And we said, didn't we, in our last video, just to check that there's no damage to the conductors that are in here. So as you pull them out, they'll be squashed slightly. Just pull that neutral out and back and just have a little look and see how fractured it is. Because if we screw into it again, you might find you snap it, cause yourself a little bit of a fault. If you're happy with that, we can insert our next conductor by the side of it. So we end up having two neutrals in the same hole, which is not a problem. And then we tighten those back up. So that's got a neutral connection to the light that's going to come on at the same time as this one. Here we go, let's do our CPC next. I've left one of the holes, so we've got plenty of room to put our CPCs in. Bringing our green and yellow sleeve in. Poke that round, green and yellow, make sure I say yellow right, I've said it yellow in one of the videos, everybody pointed that one out, so I apologise for that. CPC connection, it's not a live connection, it doesn't matter if it pokes through slightly. Make my connection for my CPC. And then this brown one will go with the blue one with brown sleeving on because it's sharing a switching line connection in order that these two come on together. So I'm going to strip that one back, so I'll use a different tool. Use my 5-in-1s, so we can go into that hole there. Not quite enough, so I'm doing it a little bit further, shows you see how precise I can be with these. Yep, in order to expose my copper. And we're going in there to share our switching line connection. So again, you might just want to check it for fracture, see how bad it is. It looks all right to me, just a little slight squash in it. And then we pop our cable in, so we share our switching line connection. Yep, that's in position, and we tighten those up. And There we go, we've dressed it, and it still looks reasonably neat, even though we've got an extra cable in it. So we've got a neutral going off to the light in the same area, same in the living area. We've got a switching line going off into the same area. So when this one comes on, it also brings on the other light now that you've wired in the area. And to make it nice and safe, we've inserted our circuit protective conductor in here. In the next video in this series, I'm going to show you how you can add a slightly different cable. Do the same thing we've done here. Take another cable so another light in the area can come on, but also so you can carry on the three plate method, and we'll explain that in the next video. But for this video, I hope this video has been some help.